Hi, welcome back to ODE. Today we are here for another unboxing. And so I have here my Victorinox knife and let's do it. And so let me tell you something about this. This is a package that I bought from eBay, a pen that I bought from eBay, and it comes from Italy. And it has an Italian pen inside. And as time goes by, I find myself more and more impressed with some Italian pens. So here is another one. Just trying to open this in the right way. Okay, it is open. I'm not 100% sure of the identification of this pen, but maybe you may help me or I will find some information someday. These are these little airbags that are very fun to pop. And here we have the box. Let's put these away and let's take a look at this. So this is a box and I think you may have a glimpse of what it is. This is the same box, I think you can see. So this is an Aurora pen and let me check the sides. Okay, let's open it, let's not waste any more time and see. So now you know this is an Aurora that comes inside this nice bag. And let's see this side. It says here Aurora fountain pen 98. So now you know this is a Aurora 98 with ink bottle and one cartridge. However, I will talk to you about this identification issue in a moment. Let's open the box. It has some extra protection inside. Newspaper. Italian newspaper. And we have here the same kind of stuff that it is inside of the newer one. This is the certificate of authenticity. It's also written in English, in Italian, but I will not do my ridiculous part of saying it in Italian. A bottle of Aurora Black, I think. However, I found that in some people, I think this was already open. No, it's not Aurora Black, it's blue actually. So nice to have a different color. Blue is not my favorite one, but it's okay. It's always nice to have an extra bottle, like if I had only a few. This is a little bit ripped, but that happens. And we have a big box, because I think this box is one of the older ones. And let's put this aside. So here you see, this is from Archivi Storici from Aurora. What I understand about these pens is that they decided to sell some of the older models in the same kind of, more recently with the same kind of packaging, and I think that's why we can get these pens like this. Let me put this away. And here we have the box. That this one looks like a vintage one. It has Aurora there engraved. And let's take a look at the pen. The same kind of stuff you can find on the newer ones. Does it have any hidden stuff beneath the pen? No, it doesn't. And here we have the pen. I don't think it has a cartridge, so that may be a problem, kind of, but or a challenge. And here is the pen. So what is this? This is the Aurora 98. However, some people say that Aurora 98, let me check something here with the loop. Some people say that the Aurora 98, there was Let me go a little bit back. That Aurora made the Aurora 88, which was this one, the vintage Pandios, a piston filler. But later they made some other variations, and they had different numbers if it was a piston filler or a cartridge. This one, as far as I understood, the Aurora 98 was available with the same name for cartridge or converters. However, I read that was in Fountain Pen Network. I will try to link that below if I don't forget about it, that discussion. They say that this little teardrop there on the clip was painted black in the Aurora 88 piston cartridge converter pen, and it was, there was also another version, a cheaper one, that was called Internazionale, which hadn't this. So it was supposed to be this one, but the box is labeled 98, and I don't find much information about the Internazionale version. So I think maybe it was just the same thing, but changed names with time and with little variation. So as far as I know, this is an Aurora 98. If it's not, please let me know. It has this very nice and texturized feeling. It looks like aluminium. It's quite light, I would say. And here you have the pen. Also, kind of a brushed finish here. I would say this one has a gold nib. I believe so. Yes, I guess, because when we look at the pen that has, let me try to focus this, that has a gold nib. Usually the nib is gold colored, and the tip of the nib, because it's not gold, it is silver colored. When you have a steel nib that is silver color, of course, and if you, the tipping is also silver color, and then it is usually all plated after that, and when it's gold plated, even the tipping gets gold plated. So this one is not the same color as the rest of the nib, and I would think this is a gold nib, and it has a very nice iridium tip. I'm looking at it through the loop. Sorry, let me just check something if it has a model name. No, it doesn't. There is this little band. I'm not sure if I can show it. Yes, I can. I didn't need the loop. It says there Aurora and nothing more. So this is a pen that was made after 1963. That's what I found on that thread on Fountain Pen Network. I don't know much more. Even this is brushed, as I told you. So this is very nice. Only this part is a shiny one. And let's see inside. I think it has no cartridge. Yes. And now this could be a challenge, because this should take the older Aurora cartridges or the Parker cartridge. Let me check. Okay, it fits Aurora Parker cartridges, so it's nice. Let me see if the length is okay. Yes, it is. So it can go with Parker cartridges. It can also go with Aurora cartridge. I was afraid of that, and let me just tell you. This one, as I told you, it is the 88, the original one, very beautiful pen. I love this pen. And you can see the kind of design is very similar. Oops. But this one is really going for the 60s and 70s with... let me show it to you. It clearly lost the rounded ends. It's more this flat ends, this even has a bevel here, so the kind of the clip is very different. It's a flat clip, but it has the kind of tear shape that is here on this clip, but then there it is, an engraving. And as I was telling you, there was this pen. This is a vintage Aurora Duo card, and this pen, let me check if I have a card. Oh, I don't. And I don't have any here with me. Sorry about that. Oh, this is a little bit of a fail, but I'm checking around. I don't think I have the other pen here. Okay. Never mind, I will show it to you when I'll make the review of this pen. Actually, I do. Let me show you. Sorry. So, let's get people complaining on the comments that I make very long videos. And I do make very long videos because of this, because I don't want to make just an unboxing. Unboxing is easy. I want to show you more about the pen. So, this is the Platinum Curidas. I have, I think, three older cartridges for Aurora, but they are left there. They are not used. This Aurora Duo Card, the vintage one, the Aurora 88 Duo Card, you can see it has this large nipple where the cartridge goes. And this is too small to fit. This is too wide to fit the opening of the Parker cartridge. But when I say Parker, you can think about Aurora, because Aurora and Parker cartridge have the same size, and also a Lamy. So even a Lamy should fit here. So you do this with a platinum that has this little ball inside that rattles all the time, but you can put this here and you have your problem fixed if you don't have access to an older cartridge for the Aurora Duo Card. So I was thinking if this one already had the new version or not. So it does, so it was easier. You just put the Parker cartridge here and put the section back and the cap, and it's good to go. This pen is really nice. I think it's very good condition. I'm not sure if the cap will scratch these, but I would say there is just a little, just a very, very tiny space where it fits here on this, over this band that is just a fraction of a millimeter wider than the barrel, and I think that's why it doesn't even touch there. I think, let me go aside for just a little moment, I think I had a spare Aurora converter somewhere, but because my house and my pen collection is always a mess, I think I don't know where it is now. So I'll try not to spend your time with this. But I don't know why I do have that. I don't know where it came from. Ah, here it is. But I have this cartridge. That is an Aurora cartridge, this converter, that is an Aurora converter, but it is a squeeze converter. I really don't know where this came from. And this should fit here. And now we have a converter for this pen. Do I like this? Actually, I prefer to use cartridges instead of converters, but if I want to get it more beautiful, it will go like this. Let me check if it can. Yes, it's nice, it doesn't rattle, it's very good. The feel of this section is very interesting. The shape is different from the older one, as you can see, because this one is more rounded, that one has that little indent there, but you can easily see that the kind of inspiration is the same. And now it's just left for me to show you the new Aurora Duo Card, which is this pen, and it is smaller. It has a bigger, longer section, but it has a smaller barrel, and you can see that all these pens have the same kind of inspiration. And if you want to put some timeline for them, you really can, because they are kind of similar. So I think this is very interesting stuff, because you have a pen that was easily inspired and it's easy to see it was inspired by the Parker 51, but then they went for cartridge pens, and this one, I was saying it doesn't rattle, but if you put it, you can hear the metal converter hitting the inside of the barrel. And then it went to this kind of shape, and now it has this one. Although the nowadays the Aurora 88 has an exposed nib, not this one. But I think it's nice to see that a pen that was a copy or was inspired by another pen. And I think it was, in my humble opinion, it was even better than the new, than the old Parker 51. You have now this pen, and you can see there is some consistency in this kind of collection. You can see where these pens came from, and it makes sense. I like to look at pens and to see evolution, when there is place for evolution. Sometimes there is just disruption and they go for something else, but it means this was not just an exercise they made and created this very famous pen, the Aurora 88, but they tried to make some adjustments, and this is what we have. So I'm very happy, and I will have to be very careful, because the hoarder that lives inside me is somehow wanting to start collecting all these pens. This posting, I'm afraid, may scratch the barrel. Maybe capping doesn't, but I'm afraid that posting will. I have to check if I will post the pen or not. I hope I can, because I really love how Aurora 88 pens or these kind of inspired pens post. I think they post very comfortably, very deep, and they are really nice to look at that way. So, this is it. I'm very happy with this pen. And if you know anything about the discussion between 98, Aurora 98, or Aurora Internazionale, please let me know, because I'm interested. So, this is all I had to show you. Another Italian pen for my collection. And I will see you soon. Bye.